First tonight, global celebrations have followed the release of the world's most famous political prisoner. Burma's pro-democracy leader Aung San Suu Kyi has enjoyed her first full day of liberty after being freed by that country's military dictators.
Her steps to freedom were met with unbridled euphoria, for Aung San Suu Kyi's 7 years under house arrest were finally over. The face of Burma's democracy movement could barely hear herself think, let alone be heard above the chants of the thousands who gathered. But even as she was given her release papers, many were asking, what now? The military junta, which seized power in 1988, has never tolerated opposition, and she's been detained for 15 of the past 21 years. In 1991, she was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize after winning an election the generals later nullified. Today's joy spread across the globe, but human rights advocates are cautious.
That we can't forget there's more than 2,200 other political prisoners held in some pretty horrendous conditions in Burma.
World leaders say free and fair elections must now follow. Julia Gillard has written a message on behalf of all Australians to Aung San Suu Kyi, whom she described as remarkable.
Certainly the Australian government would want to say to Burma that having released Aung San Suu Kyi, she should be safe and there should be no prospect that she will be re-detained in the future.
The Australian Burmese community has been celebrating too. Many fled political persecution. They understand better than most that the battle for democracy has only taken its first steps.
We are still a believer of the power of the people, so she is the symbol of that power.
But no one quite knows what the Burmese general's motivation is for releasing her, and even now, her ability to draw a crowd will be a force for those generals to reckon with. Eddie Meyer, 10 News.